So just when you've got it figured out, right, that in RNA, G pairs with C and A pairs with U, your teacher says, just kidding, sometimes G pairs with U, and sometimes there's another base altogether. Yay! Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor. Let's talk about Wobble. So for this video, you're going to want to keep a codon table handy. It's always best to work with the one that you might be using on the exam, if you know. If you don't know how to use the codon table, watch my video on that and then come back here. I'm going to keep one on the screen, but depending on what you're watching on, it may be too small for you to really use, so it's good to have one handy. If you take a look at your codon table, you're going to see 64 codons. 61 of those codons specify an amino acid, one of the 20 amino acids that we'll use in order to build a polypeptide. And the other three specify stop codons. And you may remember that the way the codons are written in the table is 5 prime to 3 prime, left to right. The codons that specify amino acids are going to be complementary to tRNA anticodons. Remember that the tRNA is going to be delivering the appropriate amino acid to the appropriate place in our growing polypeptide chain. Stop codons do not have a complementary anticodon. They don't. This is a common error. Stop codons instead are going to be bound by proteins called release factors, and those release factors are going to be critical in terminating translation. So, no tRNAs binding to stop codons, please, please, please. So, if we needed tRNAs that had anticodons complementary to each of the different amino acids specifying codons, how many different tRNA types would we need? 61, right? There's 61 codons that encode an amino acid. That means 61 different anticodons on tRNAs. So, 61 different types of tRNAs, right? Yeah, we don't make that many. We don't. For most organisms, it's somewhere between 40 and 50 different types of tRNAs, different sequences on the anticodons. For human mitochondria, it's only 22. So that means we are not making tRNAs with anticodons complementary to every single one of those amino acid specifying codons in that codon dictionary. But we're making proteins just fine. So how are we getting away with this? It's because the genetic code is redundant. Redundant means you've got more than what you need. You've got an excess. In this case, we've got multiple codons specifying the same amino acid. So find valine on your codon table. It may be abbreviated VAL or V on your table. You'll notice that it's specified by four different codons: GUA, GUC, GUU, and GUG. Well, that's typical. Most of the amino acids are specified by more than one codon. The only exceptions are methionine, the start codon encodes methionine, and tryptophan. All the other amino acids have between 2 and 6 codons that specify it's time to deliver that amino acid to our chain. And I do want to point out that three amino acids have 6 codons. They always cause a little bit of trouble because they're going to be distributed in different places on the codon table. So always look carefully. But let's go back to valine. So we already mentioned that valine has 4 codons, right? What do those codons have in common? The first two letters, right? They all start with 5' GU, and it's that third base in the codon that varies. So what anticodons would you find on tRNAs carrying valine? Pause the video if you need to think about it for a second, and hit play when you're ready. Our anticodons would be complementary and anti-parallel to our valine codons. So we know they're going to all have 3' CA, and then the base on the 5' end of the anticodon is going to vary, right? That base could change in order to be complementary with each of our four different valine codon options. And it's in that position where things start to get a little bit weird. The pairing between the 5' base on the anticodon and the 3' base on the codon can wobble. And that means there's an expanded set of base pairing rules that apply to this particular position. And that wobble is going to mean that we can get away with fewer than 61 unique tRNAs. And just a note in case your class is using this terminology, when we talk about nucleic acids, we tend to read them 5' to 3'. So the base on the 5' end would be the first position, then the second position, and then the third position of a codon or anticodon would be on the 3' end. So what we're talking about with wobble is the pairing between the first position on the anticodon on the 5' end and the third position on the codon on the 3' end. So what can happen at this position? We've got three options. The first, normal base pairing. A pairs with U, G pairs with C. We love it, right? Easy. Second option, wobble. So we've got expanded rules here, and those rules apply just to this position. So don't go wobbling the whole codon-anticodon pair. You will make way too much work for yourself, and it'll be wrong. So what happens with wobble? Well, at the wobble position, G and U can pair, either in the codon or the anticodon. Doesn't matter where the G is, doesn't matter where the U is, they can come together. So we've got a little bit of a different purine-pyrimidine base pair matchup going on here, right? The GU pair is gonna have two hydrogen bonds versus the three that you would see in a GC pairing, so it is weaker. But yeah, G and U can come together. So that means that this anticodon, which has a U in the first position on the 5' end, could pair it with two different codons, right? Normal base pairing rules applying means that U could pair with an A, beautiful, or that U could pair with a codon that has a G in the third position. Both of those codons code for valine, so that means that tRNA with that particular anticodon would be charged with valine, and it would deliver it to the ribosome whenever one of those two codons was in the A site. Okay, so normal base pairing is an option, wobble is an option. Option three, and this isn't something that all classes cover, but it's cool, we could just throw in a totally new base. Yeah, so in the first position on the anticodon, again, that's the 5' end. If there is an A, an adenine there, we can modify that adenine to create a new base called inosine, which we abbreviate with an I. And this is, again, in the anticodon only. No changes made to the codon, just the tRNA, just the anticodon could have inosine. So yeah, it's a modified A base, so we're introducing another purine into the mix. The cool thing about inosine is it's pretty flexible with who it pairs up with. Basically, anybody but G, no guanines allowed. So inosine I can pair with U, A, or with C. So this anticodon could pair, possibly, with one of three different codons. They are 5' GUA, 5' GUC, and 5' GUU. So that one anticodon could cover three of our valine codons. So you can kind of start to see how using these expanded sets of rules means we don't need to make 61 different tRNAs. We can use a smaller subset of tRNAs that can cover all of the codons. The idea of codon usage or codon usage bias is that organisms use the different codons at different frequencies. So for example, we had 4 codons for valine. But that doesn't mean that if we looked at a particular organism, we would see that 25% of the time they use GUA, 25% of the time GUC, 25% of the time GUU, 25% of the time GUG. There's a preference. You're going to see some codons used more frequently than others. In humans, you're going to see a lot of GUG, not a lot of GUA. But that's going to change based on the species that you're looking at. And so you can kind of imagine how if you're seeing these codons at different frequencies, some are a little more important perhaps than others, then you're also going to see tRNAs used and produced at different frequencies as well. So some organisms are going to have a larger library of tRNAs that they pull from. Other organisms will have a smaller one. Secondly, so even with all of these expandable rules for base pairing and whatnot, some anticodons just don't exist. You don't see tRNAs with particular anticodons. And that's on purpose for a really good reason. So find tryptophan on your codon dictionary or codon table. You'll notice that the only codon for tryptophan is 5' UGG. Now, using those expandable sets of rules that we just looked at, which anticodons could pair with this codon? Pause the video if you need to think about it. So if we just use our normal, easy peasy base pairing rules, U pairs with A, G pairs with C, G pairs with C, that's one option. Or we could wobble, U pairs with A, G pairs with C, G could pair with U. So two different anticodons could be used here. Inosine doesn't play nicely with G, so we don't have that possibility here. But that means we could have one of two different tRNAs with those two different anticodons charged with tryptophan, delivering that tryptophan wherever it sees UGG, right? Let's take another look. Focus on the wobble paired anticodon. We already know it's going to pair nicely with UGG, but what else could that anticodon pair with? What other codon is a possibility? UGA, right? Go to your codon table. What's UGA? It's a stop codon. So if UGA is a stop codon, do we want a tRNA bringing a tryptophan over to the ribosome when a UGA codon is up next? Absolutely, we do not. Right? We already mentioned stop codons. Those should be pairing up with release factors, terminating translation. We don't want to add another amino acid. We don't need a tryptophan if we're done. So because of that, tRNAs with that anticodon would not be made because they could cause problems. So if you are on the hunt for anticodons that cannot exist, pay attention on your codon table to places where the same amino acid doesn't like fill an entire box, right? Where changing that last position on the codon changes the amino acid, because that's where you're gonna find that there are cases where anticodons just don't get made. They'd cause problems. To review, although there are 61 different codons that specify our amino acids, organisms use fewer than 61 different types of tRNAs, fewer than 61 different anticodons, in order to deliver these amino acids to our growing polypeptide chain. The genetic code is redundant. Most amino acids are specified by multiple codons. These tend to differ by the third position, which base is in the third position, on the codon. At that position, three different things can happen. We can have normal base pairing with the anticodon. G's pair with C's, A pairs with U. We could have wobble, where G's and U's pair, or inosine in the anticodon can pair with A, C, or U in the codon. And remember that these expanded rules apply only to one particular position. The first position on the anticodon, 5' end, pairing with the third position on the codon, the 3' end. Different organisms have different preferences and use certain codons more frequently to specify the same amino acid. And because of that flexibility in base pairing that we've just looked at, some anticodons do not exist. Those tRNAs aren't produced by the cell because those anticodons could potentially bind with stop codons or with codons that specify the wrong amino acid. Drop me a like if you learned something about wobble today. Subscribe for even more biology from me. Check out my website for tutoring resources, and I will see you next time.